decided to keep Maria with us.
Yay!
Which is too good to be true.
Thank you.
Good stuff. Well, welcome back.
She's cute.
It's, I know.
So pretty.
Look, she matches us.
I can be in the circle. Thank
you. Well, welcome back to Sister Circle Live. It is time now for our full circle where we like to spend a little time discussing a subject that is important to us, and we know that it will be meaningful to you. And as women continue to make strides in breaking the many glass ceilings in various industries, there is one industry that is seldom addressed, which discusses gender bias, and that's sports. So today we wanted to tackle this disparity for women in sports, and we've of course had to have Maria come and talk a little bit more about what is going on in the world of sports. And I'm going to lead with this. You know, it's no secret that WNBA players are paid much less than their male counterparts. They got to fly commercial, and recently, after a series of flight delays and a 25-hour travel nightmare, the league still expected the Las Vegas Aces to play, and they were forced to forfeit the game. This is what Jalen Rose had to say in response to that ordeal. Take a look.
I've been really vocal about my disappointment for how the WNBA athletes get treated like second-class citizens in relation to the NBA when they're a subsidiary. It's one thing to have them flying commercial, but it's another thing when they have travel issues to not make accountants for them not being able to perform. You can't send an athlete out there and think 1 hour is going to be a big time difference in your performance.
Come on.
Wow. I loved him for that.
Yes. Well said. Right. What can the WNBA do, Maria, in your opinion, to prevent issues like this?
I mean, I think the biggest problem that we see in the WNBA right now, and it's not, we know that they're going to make less money than the NBA, their counterpart, but the idea that they should make a bigger share of the actual profit. So I think that there's a way to make sure that we're actually paying them what they do deserve, and they're not really doing that right now. And I think more attention has to be paid to marketing. I think they could do a better job with scheduling the timing of games, and they've done some things with the playoffs to increase viewership, but there's so much more that can be done just to promote and market these female athletes.
I have a question. Just in, I'm struggling with this with a moral situation right now. The first thing that I saw when I saw this video, well, the first thing that I thought of is, at the end of the day, these are ladies.
Yeah.
Why wouldn't you have their own plane for them? And what does it mean when the sports world will say that it is okay for women to fly 25 hours? Women.
Right.
Before anything else, they're women. What is the disconnect where you don't treat them like ladies?
Right. Well, and the interesting thing is, I mean, even when I played volleyball at Georgia, we would charter flights to Gainesville, Florida, and places like that. So, you know, we are used to female athletes get treated better almost in college than they do in the professional ranks.
And that's
even worse. Just the truth.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness. And we've seen the NFL, they hired a couple of women as coaches, a new strength and conditioning coach for the Raiders under Gruden. How can we make seeing women on the sideline as coaches an exception and not the norm?
I mean, I think the biggest thing is continuing to have coaches like Gruden, like guys like Pop. Pop added an assistant coach to the Spurs, and he's allowing her to, you know, coach on the court. And as long as there are guys that are progressive, that are setting the example, and they're going to make it a standard, and it will be the norm, and it's not going to be an exception, and we're not going to feel strange about it. It's the same way in doing sports broadcasting. At first, everyone was against it. Let's get the women off the sidelines. We don't want them to talk football. Now we're trying to get at the desk. You know what I mean? Like, and so every single step that women take and see the example, we're going to continue to
move. We're getting referees as well now. With female referees. And even the Big Three, they have a female coach as well.
Oh, good.
I want to talk a little bit about the financial component of this.
Sure.
It's been noted that the highest women NBA player, WNBA player, only makes $110,000.
Yes.
Outrageous.
That is ridiculous.
And that's not even as much as guys are making with their shoe deals.
Right. Exactly. And then I want to move on and talk a little bit about the endorsements. You don't see very many endorsements for the women NBA at all either. Why is that?
I don't understand why. I think there's a problem with strong women. In the same way that you see Serena makes less money sometimes in endorsement deals than some of her counterparts do. You know, Maria Sharapova's making more money than Serena, but she's not winning grand slams like the way she or Serena is. And so maybe men have an issue, or the people that are in charge have an issue with just a powerful woman showing her stuff all the time and dominating, and don't want to attach their brands to that. I think brands have to become hip, especially in the Me Too movement. Now's the time
right,
for a Dove or a Johnson & Johnson
Absolutely.
To say, you know what,
especially
we're going to take
Dove.
The
on,
yeah.
Right?
Yes, all
women.
Right. Right. But I think that there's some opportunities out there. Brands have to be made aware that these female athletes are interested in working with them.
So what can the people who actually go to the games, what can we do to support the movement of trying to get the ladies
first,
to get more money?
Go to the games.
Okay. Right.
The biggest thing that anyone can do that's out there, like find, if you are in Las Vegas, go to an Aces game. If you're in Atlanta, go to a Dream game. If your team is in the playoffs, show up. You know, that's the biggest thing. Like, if you prove there's an interest for it on the base level, which mm-hmm. is the fans in the arena, then you'll see brands start to come out and you'll see more people
invested. Well, why don't you think there is an interest, Murphy? Because, in, like you said, in college, mm-hmm. games are packed.
Right. Yeah.
They're packed. Mm-hmm. And this is the next elevation of their game. Mm-hmm. So, actually, the game should be packed.
Right.
What is happening? Is it an adequate, is there an inadequacy in marketing?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They're not being intentional about marketing the WNBA.
That's
because
good.
We they can only go to stuff right. they know about.
So
yeah,
is it the WNBA, the actual games that they're not marketing, or is it players that they don't have breakout stars?
Everything.
None of it. They do have breakout stars.
I'm asking, who are they? Because I couldn't pick out the last.
Well, that's the issue.
Yeah, the last WNBA player I know of is Leslie.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Lisa Leslie. And she's on TV now.
Right.
Yeah, one of the biggest problems is that you have to be able to promote. You know what I mean? So we have to do a better job with the games. And that goes for everyone. I mean,
yes.
ESPN has to put the highlights on SportsCenter for everyone to see them. And then we have to have brands that support. But I also think that we're just having an issue with the misconception that women's basketball is not as good as men's.
Yep.
And so people don't think that the athletes are as good. And because the game's not played above the rim, no one wants to watch. They want to see dunking.
Oh, they're dunking now, honey.
Yeah, and
yes,
now
they are too.
We
right.
are dunking.
Yes, they are.
And so that misconception has to be blown out of the water. And part of that is going to take marketing. It could be a social media firestorm. You know what I mean? Like, maybe there's going to be a different way to do it.
Mm-hmm. Sometimes when the higher ups don't want to do it, mm-hmm. maybe collectively as the teams
players
and the players
to
have to come
together. And we see that
together.
With the NFL, the national anthem. Like, obviously, when you take the power into your own hands, change can be made.
That's right.
And
that's
you're right about that.
I hate to say it, but I just feel like there's a piece of male chauvinism as well that is a part of this puzzle.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll go back to a friend of mine who, her name is Miss Basketball on Instagram. Mm-hmm. I love her. She's the best. But mm-hmm. she's absolutely gorgeous, very much like you, just beautiful, like a model. Mm-hmm. And they had a video of her shooting, like she was playing basketball in her heels,
mm-hmm.
and she shot the shot and it went in and everybody was like, oh, mm-hmm. and I find it interesting that they put that on ESPN.
Instead of her.
That was
her
what
sneakers.
They put on ESPN, her in her heels, mm-hmm. shooting like, oh, and even though it was dope,
right.
but it's interesting what they would choose as opposed to what's already going on
in
the blood, sweat, and tears
yeah.
that these women
That's
are having
good.
In
That's
the
good.
WNBA.
That's good. Well stated, Selena. Thank you so much.
You're welcome,
Maria.
Ladies.
We
Absolutely.
Appreciate your expertise mm-hmm. on
yes.
this. Continued success on everything
Thank
that
you,
you do,
Absolutely.
And we'll be rooting you all the way to the
and
top.
And come by some more, girl, and talk
I
about sports.
Yes.
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 All right, send us your thoughts right now at Sister Circle TV on all social platforms.
Yes.